Hey everybody, so I'm back to film my October favorites. I'm filming this kind of early. I think there's like a week left of October. But the month is coming to an end. I'm gonna be super busy the last few days of the month, so I won't be able to film this at the end of the month. So I'm just gonna post this up a few days early. Hope you guys don't mind. And for those who do, shame on you. So I'm gonna just jump into the products I've been loving this month. They're really random. Well, I think I always say that. They're always really random. I'm gonna start off with accessories for once. Just because, I don't know, I've been really into scarves and stuff because it's getting colder. I'm sure you've noticed I'm wearing a lot of different scarves in my videos. These two especially. These two are from Target. Most of my scarves are always from Target. I always list what I'm wearing in the info box anyway. But if you're wondering about these two specifically, they're from Target. They're very, very soft. I remember one was on clearance, I don't remember which one, but they're pretty affordable and the quality is really nice. I don't know, I feel like I should throw a scarf on of some sort. This one's also from Target. I don't know, scarves just complete the look. It looks just cool. I've also been loving this random hat I bought at Target. It's like an Eskimo furry hat. Is that weird? I can't help it. I really like it. I wear it a lot. And everyone looks at me like I'm crazy because it's not that cold yet, but I don't know. I think it looks cute, especially when like, I'm wearing a hoodie or something. I just find it adorable. I saw it at Target and I was like wearing it around the store and I didn't want to put it down. Random, but a favorite. Moving on. Makeup-wise, I've been loving this highlighter. I think I've been wearing it in every single video of this month. It's from Giella? Giella? I think it's Giella. That's what it looks like. This is the same highlighter and same product that Kim Kardashian wore on her wedding. On top of her cheekbones. I was reading her makeup artist's blog and he was using this in a lot of her looks and it's really pretty. I really wanted to try it out. It's a bit pricey, but at least you get a lot of it. It would last a long time. I think it's really, really pretty. I'm wearing it on my cheekbones right now. It really does give you that glamorous glow, that Kim K glow that everyone loves so much. I'll link off, of course, where I purchased it. It's pretty shimmery and it has a little bit of glitter in it as well, but I think all in all, it's blended really well that it doesn't look like too much as long as you apply it correctly. I've been applying it just with like a stippling brush. Also been loving candles. Isn't that random? I have tried the Scentsy wax non-flame burners, the thing with the light bulb, and it burns scented wax instead of candles with wicks. And then for some reason, after trying Scentsy, I really wanted to get regular candles because I find them to be very calming and soothing and pretty to have around your house. And I bought this candle from Bed Bath & Beyond. It's a Yankee candle. And I had a coupon. That's probably the only reason I really bought it. And as you can see, it's pretty much all gone. That doesn't look right. But it's a nice, soft scent. It's an ocean blossom. It's so refreshing. I want another one. So badly, I probably will get one. It's so amazing to me. Scent is a very personal thing though, something I like, not everyone else will like, and something you like, I probably won't like. I personally always lean towards the cleaner fragrances rather than the sweeter ones or the ones that smell like food. I just like refreshing scents, like the ones that are described as ocean breezes and stuff, even though what does an ocean breeze really smell like? I typically lean to like, you know, the eucalyptus and the fresher scents rather than cinnamon or like the autumn leaves scents. I don't know, those are a little too strong for me and they kind of can give me a headache. But I do like just the light refreshing scents. They're not super strong, but they're there and they have like a little calmer note to it. So I'm pretty sure I'm gonna pick up another one of these. This is a really nice scent though. Definitely take a sniff of this if you're shopping for candles. That sounded weird. Another candle I've been loving, I'm actually using it right now and I'm pretty sure it's gonna look really weird on camera. It's by Candles by Victoria. And as you can see, when it's burning, the wax melts and turns a different color. But then when it goes back to room temperature after you blow out the candle, it goes back to like the bottom color, which is weird. I'm gonna put this down before I burn myself. And that scent is in Cucumber Melon. I bought a lot of stuff off of some recommendations I got from my Facebook fan page. A lot of people said I should try Candles by Victoria and check out their website. So I ordered a couple of their refreshing scents and I've been using the Cucumber Melon a lot. I'll link more info about the size and the price and all that in the info box. But it smells really nice, refreshing. You can't go wrong with Cucumber Melon. I love Cucumber Melon everything. It just is a nice scent to me. I just bought another candle from IKEA last night. Green apple scent. I think because it's green. It has apples and it smells like apples. It's a little sour, but I like it. It really makes me want to go eat green apples. This was really, really cheap. I forgot how much this was. But it was really, really cheap. But as you can see, I'm in my candle mood. I don't know if that means I'm more sophisticated now. I don't know. But I've never been interested in candles until recently. Nail polish I've been loving this month is this polish right here. As you can see, there are boobs on the bottle, and I'm sure everyone's gonna be like, boobies! Because, I mean, that's just our natural, immature reaction to things with boobs on it. I'll be honest, I said the same thing when I first saw it in the stores. I saw this in New York at a store called Can Man Supermarket, I think, or just Can Man. 200 Canal Street in New York. It's by a brand called Scandal, and they're Korean, if I'm correct. I think the polishes are like $7 or $8 each. I really like the shade itself, not the booby bottle. I could do without, but I mean, it's cute and, you know, Asian cosmetics and their packaging. I like to be extreme. But it is the polish I am wearing on my fingers. And this is in Diamond Pearl. As you can see, Diamond Pearl. And you can see it on my fingers. I'm wearing two coats. For brushes, I've been loving. I bought a new set of brushes, even though I do not need a new set of brushes. I have enough brushes to last me my life, but I mean, look what YouTube has done to me. I was really interested in the Makeup by Renren brush set. It's called the Vortex brush set from Sedona Lace. Makeup by Renren, another YouTube guru, designed these brushes, and she did a fabulous job, I must say. So after seeing a bunch of other gurus use these brushes and talk about these brushes, I really wanted a set of my own. So I just got the one with the brush belt. It's a really nice quality brush belt as well. I'll do probably a review on its own little separate video. But I just want to mention two brushes out of the entire set that I've been really, really liking. Sadly, you can't buy them separately. You have to buy it as a whole set. The two brushes I've been loving is the flat top brush. It looks like this. This is actually dirty. I've used this twice for foundation already, and it still looks like it's super clean. Doesn't look like there's liquid foundation all over it, and it feels super clean, which I like. If you use the Sigma F80 flat top a couple of times, you'll notice like the foundation makes the bristles like glue together. And I like how this one kind of stays nice and fluffy. It's amazing. And it does just as good of a job with foundation. I used it today to buff in some liquid. It'd be great for any cream, liquid, powder product, in my opinion. And then the dome shape contour brush that's similar to like a MAC 109. Sigma also has one. I like this one a little bit more than Sigma's for some reason. I don't know why. I don't know if it's how it holds its shape, but I use this a lot for blush. I used it today for blush. It fits really well. It's right there. And you can use it for contouring as well. The handles on all these brushes are super light, which I like. They're not ridiculously heavy. It just makes it fun to use them and like spin them around. But I like this one a lot more than the Sigma one. Not sure why. The Sigma one, I guess it flares out a little bit more, and this one really retains its shape. And I haven't had any issues with washing yet, but I will talk more about these in a separate video. I just have been really loving those two brushes, and I've used a lot of other ones as well. You can see some of them are dirty. So yes, even though I keep switching up my accessories, those were my favorites for the month of October. I love this hat. I really do. Ugh, back on topic. Thank you guys as always for watching. Please comment, rate, and subscribe, and I will see you guys in a later video.